Good afternoon on this gorgeous day. So as we mentioned this week, we begin the book of Deuteronomy, Devarim, the last book of the five books of Moses, the parting book where Moses gives his last, so to speak, will and testament to the Jewish people, gives them some rebuke, some love, some guidance, some care. And in the middle, Moses tells them, after the Jews got Sinai, he reminds them, he told them, Rav Lechem Sheves Pahar Azu. Moses turns to the Jewish people and says, enough, you got to get up from the mountain. And the Rebbe tells us that everything that happens in the Torah is a metaphor. But even more so, Moses' final words to the Jewish people, when he's speaking to the Jewish people at the cusp of them going into the Holy Land when he's about to pass, is not just to the Jewish people that are there, but he's speaking to the Jewish people for eternity, to every single generation. And what Moses is telling them, sometimes we get caught up in a cocoon, we get caught up in our comfort zone, we're in the yeshiva, we're in the shul, we're in our Jewish surrounding community, we're in Israel, and we don't want to impact outside them. We don't want to have an effect beyond our grasp. We say, listen, leave me to be in my shtibo, leave me to be in my yeshiva, leave me to be in my school. I don't want to get out. Moses told the Jewish people the same thing happened when you were at Mount Sinai. It was nice at Mount Sinai, it was spiritual. You saw godliness revealed. Well, Moses, it's time to get up. Rav Lechem Sheves Bahar Azu, you got to get out of the mountain. And what does he say? Pnu Sulachem, you got to go Derech HaMidbar, through the desert. Derech HaMoyi, Hara HaMoyi, to the mountain of the Amorites. The Rebbe said the Amorites represented hatred to the Jewish people and idolatry to the lowest level. And when Moses was telling the Jewish people that you, each and every one of us, has this responsibility to leave the mountain of spirituality, of holiness, and to get out into the world that's dark, that's imperfect, that's full of hatred, and have an impact and bring light. Till when? Ad Har Gadol Nahar Pras, till you get to the Euphrates. The rabbis tell us the Euphrates will only be ours when Mashiach comes. And when Moses was telling the Jewish people, for each and every one of us till today, is that we have a job and we have a role to play. And it's not sitting on the mountain. It's not sitting with the guru. It's getting out there. And it's interesting, because when the Rebbe became the leader in 1950, that was really the message that the Rebbe sent to every single Chabadnik and to all of us all over the world. It was easy. Some people wanted to build ghettos and walls to protect their community. But the Rebbe didn't want that. The Rebbe says, we have a responsibility to impact the world, to go out there where it's dark, where it's cold, where it's hard. And that's why Chabad rabbis went to all far-flung places of the world. Chestnut Hill was the easy one, but we talk about Russia, and we talk about Ukraine, and we talk about China, and we talk about Nepal and Kathmandu, and wherever you may be, Thailand, etc., etc. And that was the Rebbe's message. We have a job to impact the world, to bring around in the Sayanic era, when this time of the 9 days, when we're sad, when we mourn, the destruction of the temple will become a time of rejoicing, of redemption. So my friends, is it easy? No. Is it possible? Yes. Is it purposeful? Absolutely. And is it rewarding? Of course, because ultimately we will have that impact. You know, I'm sitting here at camp. There's thousands of camp guys in Israel all over the world. Today we took the picture. There was nearly 300 kids. And you think about the impact multiplied to all these camps where they're impacting these children. And it reminds us of the role we have to play in the future generation of imbuing within them a love for Yiddishkeit, a tenacity to stand up for their Judaism, for their heritage, for all the things that comes with it. And that's the message that Moshe gives on his parting time.